you, Bill. I got some exciting performance here to sing a song for us. I want to introduce a group that's going to sing a special song for us. The North Country Honor Flight is pleased to welcome the Morrisonville Elementary School Chorus under the direction of music teacher Heidi Glover. The students will perform an original song titled Red, White, and Blue. The song was written shortly after September 11, 2001 by the students in Mrs. Penny Nayenhouse's 6th grade class with the help of local musician-songwriter Roy Hurd. The students composed this wonderful song about our country and what the colors in our flag symbolize to all of them. All of the words came from the students themselves, and with several days of collaboration, Mr. Hurd helped develop it into our song, Red, White, and Blue. Thanks to the students here today and for their parents who got them here very early on this chilly Saturday morning, and to Mrs. Marie Dennis for her successful efforts at coordinating this musical tribute. Give a warm welcome, please, to the Morrisonville Elementary School Chorus to sing an original song, Red, White, and Blue.
Shining through a simple
you, Bill. I got some exciting performance here to sing a song for us. I want to introduce a group that's going to sing a special song for us. The North Country Honor Flight is pleased to welcome the Morrisonville Elementary School Chorus under the direction of music teacher Heidi Glover. The students will perform an original song titled Red, White, and Blue. The song was written shortly after September 11, 2001 by the students in Mrs. Penny Nayenhouse's sixth grade class with the help of local musician-songwriter Roy Hurd. The students composed this wonderful song about our country and what the colors in our flag symbolize to all of them. All of the words came from the students themselves, and with several days of collaboration, Mr. Hurd helped develop it into our song, Red, White, and Blue. Thanks to the students here today and for their parents who got them here very early on this chilly Saturday morning, and to Mrs. Marie Dennis for her successful efforts at coordinating this musical tribute. Give a warm welcome, please, to the Morrisonville Elementary School Chorus to sing an original song, Red, White, and Blue.
Shining through a symbol.
Thank you guys so much. That was incredible. Really, thank you. All right, we've got another speaker for you. It's Dr. LaForest. Dr. LaForest served in Korea starting in 1950. He was captured in 1952 by the Chinese and was shortly after released because, get this, these are not my words, he was too much a pain in the neck. He went on to college and graduated from Plattsburgh State Teachers College in 1957. He taught in a maximum security prison in schools, colleges, universities around the U.S., and even directed the famous Farce Theater Group. While working on his master's degree at NYU, he worked in television for The Jerry Lester Show. In 1961, he accepted a position as a teacher trainer in Micronesia and established the Micronesia Radio Network. He was awarded a fellowship in 1968 and earned his doctorate at North Carolina State University. He was appointed as a congressional liaison, and it was during these years that he worked on the formulation of the Korean Memorial. He presently lives in Essex, New York with his wife Shirley Cross, where he is a member of the Essex Town Board.
Well, it's amazing. I didn't know all of us were heroes, and you're all blushing. I don't blame you. What I can't get over is these gentlemen in their uniforms. My uniform was a diaper that was filled up most times because I spent it running. It's an honor to be here and have you people. Welcome to the North Korean summer. I remember that one of the important things was to serve as a citizen soldier. All I know is that when my number was called in a draft, it took 25 MPs to find me. I ran and hid in a mine in Lion Mountain. It took another 25, almost as many people as they had on research for our friends, to bring me to the induction center, where I cried a lot. Let me tell you, I really cried. I cried so much that they sent me immediately off to basic training, where I had a chance to become an E1, but I refused it because I didn't want the added responsibility. I also want to thank Mike Farrell and my grandson, Jimmy. Mike has promised me 2 half-priced Michigans if I came here in the cold and frozen. I didn't know that Michigans were $3.50 a piece, so at $1.35 I did pretty well. I remember my trip to Korea. It was a pleasant trip. We were on a steamship that lost an engine halfway across, and I had to spend most of the time with 8 other guys rowing to get us there. I want you to know that one of my exciting experiences was I was in the 101st Running Battalion. We ran from the following battles. There's the Yellow River, Chosin, Hill number 5, Hill number 8, Hill number 27, Hill number 35, and Hill number 45. I was a pretty good runner in my day. I passed Manute Bol on a straw, and I beat the Olympic 100-yard dash champion. I was known for my ability as a combat veteran and bayonet specialist. When we were overrun by the Chinese, I found myself out of ammunition, and I immediately put my bayonet on and charged at the enemy, which turned out to be a tree. The interesting thing was my very first bayonet fight. It was with a very short Chinese. I figured I'll take this guy out, but I didn't realize he also had a bayonet that was that long. And we had one of those little stupid, silly things like that that you only use to pick your ears. We fought tooth and nail for over 2.5 hours, and we didn't get within 10 feet of each other. Now, you've heard all those lies about how cold it was in Korea. It wasn't really cold at all. We couldn't move, but other than that, I remember also on one of my heroic episodes, we were retreating from a battle when a Chinese tank got in my way. I kicked it off the road and continued with my running. Now, I picked up this little thing. It's for Korean veterans. It's a unique medal. It was the only medal from a foreign government that we are allowed to accept as a soldier. So if any of you are here, if any of you are here from Korea between 1950 and 53, you can contact the Korean embassy and they'll send you one of these things. One of these things, and $3 will get you a cup of coffee at McDonald's. Now, my uniform was not easy to be found until I was able to stumble across a Chinese who hadn't any need for his uniform. So I was able to put those on. The only thing wrong with that was they thought I was a Chinese and started shooting at me. But they were National Guardsmen, so you know they couldn't possibly have hit anybody, even if they're only 3 feet away from them. I was going to tell you that I learned several things. Let me see. I learned how to dig a foxhole on the top of a mountain with my bare hands 6 feet deep in 22 seconds. What I didn't learn is how to get out of there. I recall also that I got my first Purple Heart because as a mortar man, when we dropped a shell down in the tube, it wouldn't go off, so I looked down the tube to see what was causing it, and it took all my hair and burnt it off. My second Purple Heart was when I cut myself opening up a can of sea rations. I want you to know that it was a wonderful time, and if I had a chance to do it all over again, I wouldn't. Well, folks, I promise to keep this down to 45 minutes, and so I will. I don't want to denigrate the citizens and soldiers of this country. I don't want to denigrate the fact that what we had to do was different. In some respects, I sometimes wish I hadn't gone to Canada, but they found me there too. I want to welcome all of you for coming here tonight and this afternoon, now that it's finally gotten a little bit warmer. And I hope that I'll have the chance to be here in another 25 years. Before I go, I'd like to tell you just one story about the meetings of the Memorial Committee. We decided to put 5 soldiers in a row. And one minority group felt they should be 6 inches in front of everybody else. Well, there was a Marine Corps general there, and the final battle was Marines 5,000, minorities 2. Take a look at that statue. I posed for one of them. It's the one that the birds all use. Thank you very much for being here, and God bless all of us. God bless America.
I think we're all a little bit more warmed up after that. Thank you. Thank you for your words and the laughs. Next, I'd like to invite Bill Long to play Taps and the Rifle Salute by post number 20. And this is for all the Honor Flight veterans who have passed, as well as all the veterans who passed before getting their chance to go on an Honor Flight. I'd like to introduce Harry Treadway, and he's going to give us a couple of bios about some of our veterans who will be going on the trip today.
Good morning, everybody. As we, as some of us remember, whenever the military wanted us to move, we had to have a bunch of paperwork with us. So for these gentlemen today, we're going to give them a set of orders that will allow them to go down to Washington, D.C. and return. First one up we have today is Gerald E. Abbott, U.S. Army. Gerald was is a World War II vet, served in the European theater as a medical squad leader in northern France. Our next veteran is Walter F. Brockway, U.S. Army. Walter's a World War II vet. He was with the 169th Infantry Regiment as a truck driver. Our next veteran is William L. Cross, U.S. Navy. William served during the Korean War on an aircraft carrier. Next veteran is Douglas J. Dupree, served in the United States Army. Douglas served during the Korean War, was with the Signal Corps 701st. Next veteran is John J. Harvis. John served in the U.S. Army. John's a World War II vet. He was in the European theater with the 395th Infantry Regiment as a truck driver hauling prisoners of war. John was awarded the Bronze Star and earned a Combat Infantry Badge. Our next veteran is William M. Labonte. William was a U.S. Marine. William's a World War II vet, a Korean vet, and was a military police and an infantry officer. Next veteran is Carl C. LaFontaine in the U.S. Army. Carl served during the Korean War as a payroll clerk with the 2nd Infantry Division, which had casualties in Korea of over 7,094 men. Carl received the Bronze Star. Next veteran is John J. Neji. John served in the U.S. Army. John served during World War II with the 76th Infantry Division on the front lines for 3 years in Europe and Africa. John also received the Bronze Star. Our next veteran is Joseph R. Rodriguez. Joseph served in the Air Force. Joe's a Korean vet and was a radio operator for the Boomers and the Jets. Actually, he was a radar operator, I'm sorry. Our next veteran is J. Rodney Stone. Rodney served in the Navy. Rodney's a Vietnam War vet, was a machinist mate, third class. Our next veteran is Ronald L. Trombley. He served in the U.S. Army. Ron was in the infantry during the Korean War. Our next veteran is Timothy T. Tryon. Tim served in the U.S. Navy. Tim is a World War II vet. He was on the USS Hornet during the Project Magic Carpet in the Pacific. Veteran is H. Allen Walker. He served in U.S. Navy. Allen is a Korean War vet as a radio man on the USS The Sullivan, which was a destroyer. Our next veteran is Norbert C. Yakey. Norbert served with the U.S. Marines. Norbert's a Korean vet. Worked as a clerk typist, S4, learning how to combat load ships. And that is our group of veterans going on this honor flight. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, you guys. Finally, close to the end here, we've got Dick Adams, who's going to send us off with a prayer.
Let us bow. God in heaven, we just thank you for this day. We thank you for this opportunity to honor these veterans. We thank you for our nation and the mercy and the grace that you've shown it over the years. We thank you for the faithfulness you show us as we recognize our foxholes. And we ask that you would go with these veterans today, bless them, let them see and hear and be encouraged for the lives that they've given our nation and our country. Let us remember those that have gone before us. And we just thank you for your faithfulness again. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thanks, Dick. And finally, Pauline Stone is going to introduce our veterans for their walk of honor before they load the bus.
Gerald E. Abbott.
These are our solemn moments as they bring the participants for the North Country Honor Flight. Interview and load them on the bus. They'll be taken to the airport where they board their flight for Washington, D.C. Talk about the two young men standing next to them who salute. You see the two young guys sitting there. Her husband, Dr. Al Walker, a dear friend. Often we see him playing the bagpipes in various ceremonies and events, and he's going on the trip today, and I think that's terrific.
I don't think Al would want to wear his kilts today.
I don't think so either, regardless of what they put underneath them. Yeah, I know. So he's been to the Highlands of Scotland more than once, so I'm sure he's familiar with the weather. I don't think the weather is warm very much, either that or I'm below the tolerance level. It was 37 degrees when we arrived here about 6:15 this morning. After this is over, Calvin and I will do our normal rush over to the airport to watch the troops arrive there.
It'll be a great day.
There used to be a ceremony inside the airport terminal, but it's being constructed now, so that's why we've moved it outside. Albeit kind of cool for that kind of event today, but the turnout is just terrific. One of the biggest crowds we've seen here in a long time. Wheelchairs are provided, of course, for any of the veterans who need them, especially down in Washington, D.C., where they're taken to their various memorials. Nice of Janet Dupree and Elise Stefanik to be on hand to greet each one of these veterans and their guardians. Give them a nice warm hug before they get on the bus and head out. And lastly, our veteran who is on this flight, who is rather feeble and ill, and his last wish was to make this flight today, and we hope it's a very special time for him. Lots of photographs being taken.
Thank you.
least the sun is out, and it gives us the impression that it's a lot warmer than it is. So people watching this program are probably saying to themselves, what are they complaining about? It's cool, friends, and there is a brisk wind blowing to add those dreaded words, chill factor. Said last, but it wasn't last at all. There are several more. I wasn't keeping track.
You had a good flight. I will.
Warm me up. Good morning, Jim.
Thank you.
We'll leave here in a few minutes. Some of the cash appeared later with a note saying, I'm very sorry. Michaels and various other folks. Here come the pipes. Times reporter. New York Lotteries last night.
9, 2, 1, lucky sum 20, take 5, 10, 17, 18, 26, and 37, your Mega Millions last night, 4, 14, 29,
30. Oh, my Al would be playing with it, Luke. Special congratulations, and I'm sure Calvin Kastein and Hometown Cable would like to add his to Harry Treadway, who heard him taking a part that would normally be done by George King today and talking about the service of the various people that are going on the trip. But he has also organized this motorcycle escort ever since the very first honor flight some time ago. He's a good friend, he's a stalwart citizen, and he is a champion biker, I'll tell you that, to drive all the way from Ticonderoga this morning to lead this parade today. So we give Harry and his large group of bikers, look at them all, special credit for being here. Once again, we're part of the North Country Honor Flight. On October 3rd, 2015, from the old base Oval, former Plattsburgh Air Force Base, just a few days ago, commemorating the fact that the air base officially closed 20 years ago. And now the bikes are underway. We'll get to follow the parade out of here, and then we'll scurry, as much as two old guys and a camera can scurry, over to the Plattsburgh International Airport to watch them as they enter the terminal and prepare for their flight to Washington, D.C. It is indeed an honor to be part of this standing on the periphery with the hometown cable cameras and recording everything. We have the New York State Police. We have the Clinton County Sheriff's Department. State University Police in the beginning. Other emergency vehicles as they pass by, we'll talk about them. Fire truck. And of course the bus with veterans. If you don't think the North Country cares, just look at the group that turned out today. This is one of the biggest parades for the veterans of the North Country Honor Flight that we've seen. Number of people from the state police, there's the sheriff's department with their vehicles in line. Look at them all. You should be proud of all the agencies that come together, including individuals and the North Country Honor Flight group itself. And here they come. We'll wave at them as they go by. The sun is shining, but I doubt if it's much more than the 37 degrees that it was when we started here early this morning, almost before sunrise. And the last contingent, engine 284 from the city of Plattsburgh. Well, we made it in time for the parade, and we're at the Plattsburgh International Airport, right at the entrance, where a lot of construction going on, as our viewers probably are aware. The North Country Honor Flight Parade is arriving. We're the large contingent of motorcycles, and we once again salute them, Harry Treadway and the group. I hope they dress warmly. Look at the group. One of the largest groups we've seen since the very beginning. The thermometer in the car showed 40 degrees as we pulled in. I don't know if it actually raised 3 degrees in the interim, but it still feels chilly. Although I think that we're out of the wind where we're standing now, or most of it anyway. Many of these programs, as Calvin and I have done, it's still a huge thrill for me to record this for you and for those people in far in the future who want to watch this program to honor our veterans through the North Country Honor Flight. And this is a process that's being replicated many times across the country as we're honoring just as many of our veterans as we possibly can, and here comes the bus. A relatively small group gathered here on this cold Saturday morning, the third day of October 2015 at the airport. We've seen larger numbers here when they held a ceremony inside in times past. It'll take a little time to, deplane the veterans, to offload the veterans, get them into the airport, get them ready for their flight. It's kind of a whirlwind event for those of you who are not familiar with the North Country Honor Flight or honor flights in general, because they have to make the trip to Washington, D.C., and then they have to be taken to the various memorials. And I don't know if this group will be going to Arlington National Cemetery today, but I'm guessing they will, because it's a very important part of the total package of history, if you will. And then they'll be treated very well throughout this course of this day as they try to drink in this tremendous history involved, and they'll connect their own memories with what they'll see at these memorials, and they'll be, for some, an almost overwhelming and certainly deeply moving and touching experience. And the plane will return theoretically to Blacksburg International Airport at about 10 o'clock tonight. And they're generally a nice group of people, well-wishers, friends, relatives, who greet them when they arrive. And if we haven't mentioned it enough times here today, there is a guardian for each one of these veterans who make the trip with them. And these guardians are show tremendous dedication all by themselves by generally supporting financially the trip. Sometimes they're relatives, generally they're friends, and sometimes they're complete strangers who just volunteer to do this.
Well, Gordy, we got to keep mentioning, I think, the October 17th date, because a lot of people are probably like us and had October 31st on their calendar, but they've moved that date up 2 weeks to the 17th. So
we won't be doing it on Halloween Day after all. I don't have to bring my carved pumpkin along, I guess. It's amazing how people begin to celebrate holidays long before the event. A couple of weeks ago, I saw the Christmas trees showing up in various stores. I saw people putting out Halloween decorations, which didn't even happen except for the ones we put up on trees in people's yards on Halloween many years ago. So it's become a major holiday. And it almost seems like people are bypassing some of the other major holidays like Thanksgiving. But people have their decorations up already, and I saw some of my own relatives and my brother's children and grandchildren down in Pennsylvania making jack-o'-lanterns, and not just the triangle eyes and nose and mouth like we used to do, but I mean fancy stuff. And with lights inside that blink and so on. So we kind of enjoy Halloween. We don't have any small kids at home, of course, at our house, but we don't have any dogs to greet them anymore, but we love to greet the kids that come to our house in Morrisonville. I haven't heard whether they found a home for their haunted house this year, did they? They were searching as of a few days ago, and they hope to find one by this weekend. The big haunted house to raise money for the firefighters has been an ongoing tradition and a strong one for a long time. But they're running out of venues since they have to find a place that doesn't cost them money, where they have electricity and sewer facilities. And here they come. The crowd wasn't very large, but they're appreciative. So much larger when the new additions and construction are finished. The more jetways, a lot of new facilities that the people who built the airport a few years ago could only have imagined in their wildest dreams. Thank you. proud to be part of the North Country Honor Flight in a small way from the very beginning. We wear our hats and our t-shirts and our jackets each time we do one of these shows. Know what they're going to see having been indoctrinated, but they'll know the thrill of it in a very few hours. And three from the Champlain area. That's pretty good, Kelvin.
One from Morris.
Yeah. That bus ride's a little better than the one we went down to Albany in the first time. That was quite a ride, I'll tell you that. I can't help but think of those motorcycle riders escorting that first trip all the way to Albany. Are there any more? I can't tell. Is there more? Any more coming? I can't tell. Maybe so. Yeah, a wheelchair. Sky's relatively clear on this third day of October, and the sunrise was really quite pretty, but it's remained cool and will be cool throughout the day and weekend. No frost at my house yet. Okay. Those people who were thoughtful enough to bring a pair of mittens or gloves this morning are now not suffering as much as some of those who were. I felt bad for the gal, the teacher from Morrisonville, who had to play the guitar with frozen fingers. Now we have the last honor flight member off the bus in the wheelchair. Somebody else coming, yep. It's nice to be able to have a bus with a wheelchair accessible lift. It's so nice when various people and Calvin Castine shows up with a camera to chronicle these events for people who will be here or maybe won't be here 20, 30, 40 years into the future, who can see what the honor flight was like in 2015. Well, it's been a great pleasure for us to be part of North Country Honor Flight October 3rd, 2015. Calvin and I want to mention again that the next one will be coming up on October 17th, and that's a change from the originally planned Halloween Day 1, October 31st. It's always a kick for us to be involved in the North Country Honor Flight, and this one, in spite of the weather, was enthusiastic and well attended by so many people. Thanks to everyone involved in planning the honor flight. Thanks especially to these veterans to whom we owe so very much in our nation's freedom. Thank you for your suggestions and support of our little corner. If you care to make a generous contribution to keep the program going, please come up to Calvin and hand him as much as you can afford to help this program. Or write a generous check today and send it to Calvin Castine in care of Hometown Cable, 1477 Ridge Road in Champlain. Congratulations to the Honor Flight for another job well done. Who knows where we're going to be next time for our little corner.